4 of attending ATP pilot school, and oh my gosh, I am tired. I was like ready for pilot school, but I was also not ready for pilot school. Like, I've really had to reprioritize a lot of things in my life. So I'm spending a lot less time on social media, creating more boundaries with time, with spending time with friends. This first week was a lot. I got there and like didn't have my cushion because I think someone took it from my car when my car got broken into. So couldn't even have seat in the plane. The plane seat only went up but so high. So I bought a quick cushion at the store next door for the next day. And that day the flight went amazing. Like I feel really good though about the overall program. Like things feel very organized. It feels very doable. And it feels as though as long as you're reading and studying and you're making sure you genuinely understand the content, then you can really learn everything you need to learn and you will truly thrive and get whatever position you are trying to get. With new stages of life and new places of growth, you're going to have to let go of comfort. I was so cozy in my blanket. I had my remote job, not going anywhere. I was so comfortable. It was hurting me. And I had a whole month to start studying and getting myself together for ATP in this full-time flight program, but I was not ready to start actually studying and doing the work because I was already too comfortable. So that got chopped off in the nuts ASAP. But dang, ATP taught me this much, some major life content this quick. I'm not here to be stagnant for the next 10 years of my life. I am here to grow each and every year, and that is what ATP is setting me up for. That is what God is setting me up for, and that is what I am setting myself up for. That first day, I forgot a lot of my documents. I forgot my cushions. I forgot I was tired. I couldn't have remember crap. I know the guy was looking at me confused. The second day, I was late. I was just starting off miserably. And I had to tell the guy, listen, like I might be starting off tough, but sit together. Just give me some time to get it together. And here we are at day 4 and things are really pulling itself together nicely. So I'm taking this a lot more seriously. I'm talking with a little bit more bass in my voice about this because before I was lollygagging, here I'm not playing no more. Nothing can get in my way. Cause why? God has me, sis. This is day 14 of ATP pilot school. I'm a little less exhausted. I've been studying like crazy for my PAR, AKA private, for the knowledge test to become a private pilot. They really tell you to take these tests prior to you arriving to ATP, and you really should. If I had already had this test done, then I would have been able to focus a lot more on just flying, which would have been a lot easier. However, it's gonna get done. My deadline, you get like 21, 22 days to complete the test off your start dates. I've been using the private pilot Gleam test prep, also Sporty's pilot buddy. They have an app that's like $14. Go ahead and buy that and then you can really do the test questions and you'll be ready. Outside of that, everyone is really nice. People are really devoted to making sure you're the best you and you're the best pilot. I love our group meetings every week. We have like 2 or 3 of them. And it's just good to reiterate, like you're reading the books, you're watching the videos, you're in the classrooms, and it just starts sinking in. And it's like, wow, okay, the first week is overwhelming because it's all this information. You're like, oh my God, learning information everywhere. It's OD. The second week is like, oh wow, I'm actually retaining it. Or wow, I actually know a lot more than I thought because I've just been hearing it, seeing it, reading it, you know, over and over again. So it's good. This week, we've also been working on takeoff and landings, and the weather has been like either rainy or super windy. So it hasn't been the best, but I'm definitely improving with my landings. And my takeoffs had always been great, so.
After using the Gleam to study, studying chart supplements, using Sporty's private pilot app, as well as the PHAC and AFH, and taking tons of notes, of course, I finally passed my private knowledge test after day 22.
So you're an artist.
Yeah.
Are you good at it?
Okay, put the filter on for you guys just to bless your eyes. About to fly and do my night flight. We are at day
67, so I'm about 2 months in. I have passed my PAR exam. I have soloed by myself now. I've done my cross-country evaluation, so I've flown to like South Carolina, and I'm about to do it by myself for the first time. The whole trip is long. Like, it's a good 3-hour trip. Afterwards, I'm a little like ready for a nap, but still raving about Alpha Tango Papa ATP. And it's a good experience. I love everyone I'm surrounded by. We all have a little group chat and we do like study things and stuff. I'm just really excited. I'm really happy. I'm close to check ride for my private pilot license. So once I get that, then you start learning about instrument, which they say the real fun begins, because it's more like how you'll be in the airlines, right? So you'll be kind of flying based off your instruments and not visual because you'll be in the clouds. So really excited for that. Things are going good. I'm about to run and do my night flight and learn about all of the different optical illusions that can happen, like false horizon and autopenesis.
Hey guys, so this is like maybe day 78. And I've done 2 solo cross countries. It is so beautiful doing that flight. And I swear to God, I almost got emotional because I'm like looking at the mountains and I'm like, wow, it's so beautiful. How did I get here? Oh my God, Ashley, wow. The weather has been horrendous in Atlanta. So it's been taking a lot longer for me to finish the solo. Like, you really could get done in a week. It'd be TOLs and then I'll be done with the solo section and I'm starting check ride prep. So to start taking my mock oral exams, getting all the maneuvers down pat, this time I'll be able to practice like the short field and soft field takeoff. So excited for that, by the way. Flight was so smooth. The solo cross country was so fun and beautiful. Just bring tons of snacks. Like, my God, I was so hungry. I even brought snacks and I was hungry. But so far, so good. I'm just studying a whole lot, getting ready for this oral exam, going over my written PAR. They have like the list of areas that you maybe didn't get right. And remembering all the acronyms, A, tomato flames, flaps, fuse, you know, flaps, claps, whichever one you use, pave, aviate with the number one.
Hey guys, today is like April 11th. My start date was January 9th. So it's been like almost 3 months. I am in check ride prep. So I literally have one flight left before I take my private pilot state exam. Do my oral, do my check ride. I'm so excited. Do I feel ready? Just about. I think I could do some extra buffing up on like the knowledge section. But in terms of like my flying maneuvers, just like little things here and there. Like, I like to fly looking outside, right? As you should, because you're VFR flying or visual flying. But sometimes when you look inside, it can throw everything all off. Well, I think because I'm so like nervous and jittery and stressed that like, oh my God, my check ride's coming up. I'm paying more attention, to the inside and making sure my instruments look great. I'm losing focus of the outside and it's throwing me all off. So my steep turns are like a hot wreck. But they were beautiful like 2 weeks ago, a month ago. So it's just like, I gotta really chill out, take a deep breath, woosah, look outside, feel the plane, enjoy it, and trust the process, so. But hopefully next week I'll be endorsed and scheduled for my state exam. Other than that, I still really like ATP. They are allowing me to change my instructor. I probably will change my instructor just because like they're a Pisces. And not too deep on the zodiac, so like Sagittarius and Pisces are not the most compatible. And I think like we have communication barriers. So I think it'll be like good to get another perspective for instrument, and yeah, but I'm loving this heat. I need to get me some khaki shorts and some tennis skirts.
You are not looking at a passenger princess anymore. You're looking at a private pilot. Y'all, I passed my private pilot check ride. And I'm so happy. I am so happy. It was a long time coming. I probably am somewhat of a tough student. I can be a little stubborn and stuff, which has made this even harder. But when I tell you, this experience has like made me grow in so many different ways. I'll give you all the tea, right? So I did my private pilot check ride with a man that's a captain at Southwest Airlines. He was so sweet, giving straight grandfather vibes, was so here for it, down in Alabama. It was a challenge for sure. Yeah. I had never tried. So obviously we do pilotage and dead reckoning, which is being able to fly the plane without GPS. You just go based off like visual cues. So like I see a building to my right. I knew I was supposed to see that in 5 minutes. And you kind of do like all your routes that way. And you did all of that. And that was good. I made my points. And then he was like, okay, go ahead and divert. Still not using GPS, just strictly dead reckoning. So I'm like, okay, let me find a place. And he's okay, where are you on this map? And it was good. Like everything I was actually able to do, which was nice. And it's like, you don't know what you're able to do until it's time to be able to do it. So it was really, I think that whole exam was just really nice that I will show up for myself when it's time to show up for myself. And I was tired. I stayed up till 12 a.m. just kind of reviewing my notes. And I was just like, I guess I do know this stuff. And the night before, like I had friends, like family friends come into town. So we went out to eat and was hanging out a little bit. The night before that, I went to like a really nice dinner, got this steak. Okay. And that was really yummy and good. I like felt really sound going into this whole exam. Was God. Yeah, God just kind of like, I got you, girl. And I just felt very well prepared. And I did do a check ride binder. I can send you guys the link or kind of refer you guys to the video. Bend your hand on the yoke at all times and the throttle at all times. That went a long way because it promotes safety. I'm tired. I was so nervous. Like our plane was supposed to be at our location, but it was at a different location. So we Ubered to the other location to get the plane. And then we get there and the plane's not even there. We're like, why did they tell us that it was at a different location? So we took somebody else's car all the way back to our original location and the plane was there. So it was like a whole hour at like 6 to 7 a.m. just running around and trying to like just leave to go ahead, you know, to fly to the destination for the check ride. But I passed, y'all, and I can fly anywhere I want to now.